We just, like, lost touch with each other. I never talked to him anymore. So, if you love somebody, don't let him slip away. I swear to you.
Your mama know you smoking that, bro. Your mama know you smoking that.
My mama dead, bro. You good, though?
Remember, just remember the day that you called me crying, and I was here for you. Remember that day?
Yeah.
Stop. What's the fucking thing, man? Don't tow it away on me. Cost me money. I don't have any money, dude. I'm broke, man. My life sucks. You're making it worse. No, you don't.
Downstairs to get something to eat.
I hate my school, I hate my friends, and I hate this family. I hate everything about my entire stupid life. So you can ground me, Dad, and you can yell at me, and you can do whatever the hell you want, because honestly, I wish I was dead. I don't feel anything anymore, and you want to know the best part? I don't even care.
The saddest fucking shit is the people that are the most broken and are hurting and are the saddest are the ones that would do absolutely anything for anyone else, because they know the pain, they know what it feels like, and they don't want anyone else to have to go through that. But in doing so, they break even more, because nobody ever does that for them.
I'm okay. If you don't leave today, I'm
suddenly you realize you'll never have the good relationship you wanted. And as long as they were alive, even though you'd never admit it, part of you, the stupidest goddamn part of you, was still holding on to that chance. You know, sometimes I feel like I was born with a leak. And any goodness I started with just slowly spilled out of me, and now it's all gone. And I'll never get it back in me. It's too late. Sometimes it feels better not to talk at all about anything. I'm not the perfect guy. I actually kind of hate myself a lot of the time. But when I'm with you, I don't hate myself. I like being around you. And I don't know if I ever told you that in so many words. So I'm telling you.
Dad always told me, don't you cry when you're down. But Mom, there's a tear every time that I blink. Oh, I'm in pieces. It's tearing me up, but I'm...
Hello, Mom?
Yes?
I just got a $5,000 donation on my stream.
What?
I just got a $5,000 donation on my live stream. So I'm making $5,000. I can get a car now. I know. Are you proud of me? Are you happy that I didn't go to college?
You win. You wanted me to stop talking to you and texting you? You got it. You wanted me to leave you alone? You got it. You wanted your space? You fucking got it. Guess you don't need me anymore. Probably never will. But that one day when you try to reach back out to me, I won't be there. Because you didn't listen to me when I was there. You didn't hear me when I was there. You didn't answer me when I was there.
You helped me fight when I was getting
Yeah, I'm not perfect. But at least I know I tried.
And you made
so don't expect me to try when you're ready.
Can I show you something?
Morty, no offense, but a drawing of me you made when you were 8 isn't gonna make me feel like less of an accident.
That, out there, that's my grave.
Wait, what?
On one of our adventures, Rick and I basically destroyed the whole world. So we bailed on that reality, and we came to this one. Because in this one, the world wasn't destroyed. And in this one, we were dead. So we came here, and we buried ourselves, and we took their place. And every morning, Summer, I eat breakfast 20 yards away from my own rotting corpse.
So, you're not my brother?
I'm better than your brother. I'm a version of your brother you can trust when he says, don't run. Nobody exists on purpose. Nobody belongs anywhere. Everybody's gonna die. Come watch TV.
I used to be the person that no matter how bad you hurt me, I'd still stick by your side and be there for you. But I eventually realized that shit had to stop because that's how you allow people to take advantage of you and allow them to continuously step all over you. I'm glad to say that I'm not that kind of person anymore. My loyalty kept me in situations my common sense should have taken me out of. I was doing so much for someone who wouldn't even think to check up on me. And if they did, they only checked up on me to see if I was okay enough to come through for them. I let the love I had for someone blind me so much to where I gave them my all, and went above and beyond while they were playing me and giving me below the bare minimum. I was giving them more than I was giving myself. I was so loyal to them to the point where I betrayed myself. And so, personally, never again.
Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me when my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call. Of my Savior, and I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves.
Medical examiner, is my son dead? Yes, I'm yes, not my husband, yes, my son dead! Babes, pull over right now, babes! Pull over, just pull over. Pull over right now. Pull over. Pull over, she said medical examiners, babe. She said medical examiners! Is my son dead?
I used to be so fucking happy. I used to be happy. I don't know what's wrong with myself. I used to be so pure-hearted. That all changed, and I became quiet, unhappy, tired all the fucking time. I don't want to socialize. I stay in bed all day when I can, in sleep, to block out reality. I use music as a way to escape, but it doesn't really fucking work. It just helps. You know, I envy people that are happy. I've got a family that doesn't really fucking family. And when they do, I feel like the fucking black sheep. I wish I was someone else. I wish I was happy. I've got a short attention span. I zone out a lot. I used to want to come out all the fucking time. But now all I want to do is stay home, locked up in my room, sleeping, watching movies and listening to music. I'm starting to fucking hate myself. I overthink everything. Every fucking thing. And this smile that I put on is so fucking fake. Deep down inside, I am slowly fucking giving up. I don't know what to do or how to express myself.
I'm looking at the
listen, ain't no woman gonna leave you because you made a mistake, because you messed up. You understand what I'm saying? Most of the time, women don't leave because you openly made a mistake and you came back and you owned your stuff and y'all decided to work it out, because that's what we do. The problem is when you get forgiven for that mistake and we try to work it out with you, then you turn around and you do that same mistake over. Then that same mistake over. Then that same mistake over. See, you ain't get left because you made a mistake. Ain't nobody will walk out on you or abandon you because you made a mistake. We walked out and we left you because you made it a pattern. You know what I'm saying? You made it your norm. You understand? Ain't nobody gonna sit back and just wait on you and keep begging you to do right, to do the right thing, to see them as worthy, to love them correctly, to respect them, to respect y'all relationship. You lost your woman because of you. You didn't lose her because she wanted to leave. She left you because she had to leave.